We all like being happy, but sometimes we feel sad. 1 in 10 kids in the UK has a mental illness. Among them, 90,000 have depression.
This is a special programme about kids who feel down and how they're getting better.
There's been a lot recently in the news about depression, and most experts agree that the number of kids affected is going up. It's different from feeling low for a day or two. It's when you feel down for a long time and the feelings don't seem to get any better or go away. We're going to hear from kids about their experiences and how they're getting help.
Day to day, you can just feel so different. You don't know what's around the corner. You can just feel like staying in bed all day, and the next day you can feel like running a marathon.
When Jill was 12, she was bullied. She's been feeling really down since. She has trouble sleeping, and sometimes she's confused about what's going on in her head. Jill is getting help now from her family, her doctor, and a special mental health project which offers kids support. We've changed Jill's name and protected her identity.
It's 9 o'clock, Thursday evening. Today's been a rough day. Had about 2.5 hours sleep maximum last night. Feeling shattered now. Today's been a really up and down day for some reason. When I woke up, I was feeling quite down. Then by period two at school, I was fine. Then came home. By about 8 o'clock, I was feeling down again. The future now is a lot different to how it could have been, because if I hadn't told anyone, I would have been stuck in a hole with no one to help me get me out. But now it feels as if there's someone with a ladder. The whole future's looking brighter now that I've got support and told people.
So what is depression and how does it affect people? This is David Trickey. He's an expert who helps kids if they're feeling worried or sad.
We all feel a bit down from time to time, and that's completely normal. But depression is when that feeling doesn't go away. Sometimes depression can come out of the blue, but often there's a particular reason for it. Things like being bullied, being treated differently, someone dying or having an illness, parents arguing or splitting up, and friendships not working out. Depression can make people feel sad, tearful, moody, angry, and tired. They might have trouble concentrating, sleeping, and eating, and it can stop people doing things that they used to enjoy doing.
For some kids affected by depression, even day-to-day things like going to school can be hard. Charlotte has been depressed since she was 13.
My mum died when I was 4, and that was particularly hard to deal with, and that was the first time I felt really upset. There are things that you shrug off as a child, and then one day it becomes all too much, and all the feelings that you've bottled up come back, really. And it's a mixture of anger, sadness, and fear, and you don't know how to deal with it. You know, you don't get a textbook at school saying that this is the emotions you're feeling and this is what it is, so you don't think it's depression. You know, you don't know what it is. You don't understand why you feel the way you do.
But Charlotte is getting help. Doctors give her medicine. She speaks to an expert about her feelings And she goes to this special unit called the Hope Service, where depressed children who have trouble going to school get education as well as support.
This is a dining room where we have our meals. And this is a chill-out room. We have lessons every day, so this is our classroom. This is the art room where we get to express our feelings. And this is a group room where we all get to chat to each other. Hope has offered me support and therapy and something to lean on, if you get what I mean. Whereas before, I didn't feel like I had much support because parents and teachers and friends aren't experts in the subject. They don't know how to deal with it. I never saw a future before. I thought, well, I'm going to live and die and that's it. You know, I'm not going to achieve anything. But I can smile and I can be happy. And I never thought I would think this way, but I do.
Can she get there? Come on, Kelly! One more yard! Come on, Kelly Holmes! It's goal! Kelly's won the goal for Great Britain! You won it, Kelly! You won it!
Kelly Holmes won 2 gold medals at the last Olympics, yes, but sometimes even champions have low points.
The gold medal! Kelly Holmes is the Olympic champion! Oh, what a race!
An injury just a year before her double Olympic triumph left Kelly suffering depression.
The main feelings when you have the depression is feeling like the world's ended and that there's nothing kind of positive for you to strive for. It's really hard to describe why you get into that stage, and I didn't realise that I could get as low as I did. I think I better run. I think any children that feel down or think they might have depression should always find somebody to talk to. It's the best thing that can ever happen because it makes you realise that there are people there to support you. There is something for everybody in life, especially children, and there's always such a future ahead of them. And, you know, like me, I had the dream when I was 14 years old to be Olympic champion, and no matter what went on in my life, I still achieved that dream 20 years later. So there's always hope for everybody. Run,
run, run. I think I better run. Getting through depression isn't easy. Often the idea of talking to a doctor can be scary. Jake is 12. Both he and his 9-year-old sister Shelley are seeing an expert. But for them, it can actually be fun.
You've chosen really lovely, bright, happy colours there. How come, Jake?
They use art to express and understand their feelings. They've asked us to hide their faces and change their names.
My mum and dad first split up ages ago. Then me and my sister started arguing. Then my nan got cancer in her lungs, so that just makes me feel sad and angry.
That sounds like an awful lot to deal with. How did art therapy help you?
Art therapy is all about not creating a perfect piece of art. You can muck about, do whatever you want, basically, as long as you speak about your problems or show your problems through art. Through art therapy, I've found all ways I can channel my anger into art, and it makes me feel a lot better.
Things don't always work out. There's always a way of making things better, yeah? Then you'll think about all different things and all of a sudden, like, things come together and then begin to make sense.
We use different coloured paints. Some paints show my feelings, like the colours. The glitter just shines and makes me happy. I've understood myself a bit better because my art therapist's been there for me. She always tells me what I've got to try and do. She listens really carefully. She says, is anything worrying you? And I tell her what's worrying me and she tries her best to sort it out.
Depression can affect thousands of children every year. It can be a lot to cope with. The first step to getting better is to talk to someone about it. All the kids in this program have been brave. They've chosen to talk to a friend or adult they trust about how they feel. It could be a parent, a teacher, a doctor, or someone on the end of a helpline. Talking can help a lot, but there's also loads of other support available out there. The Newsround website has information about what to do if you're worried about yourself or a friend.
Depression is a growing problem among kids. Some experts say that it's because we're becoming more aware of mental health. Others say that there are more pressures on kids and they find life tougher to deal with. All the children we've spoken to are getting better and say they're looking forward to a brighter future.
There's a light at the end of the tunnel. Even if you can't see it, it's there.
You should always get help from people that understand you and can help you through your problems.
I think when people my age hear the words mental health, they think crazy, psycho, loony. I think it should be viewed just the same as physical health. Mental health needs to be looked after.